Hi everyone, Chef from Outdoors in the Low Countries. Now next to me you see the Cut 60. This is a plasma cutter that I used for already quite some projects. Some of them you can see on my channel. And this plasma cutter comes without pilot arc. Now without pilot arc you need to make electrical contact with the workpiece which is connected to the earth clamp in order to get the ignition. Now here you see an example of a torch with pilot arc. Now what's the advantage? With pilot arc it automatically starts. So you don't need to make a physical contact of the torch with your workpiece. And the advantage is that you then can use a distance holder, like you see over here, which you cannot use with a normal torch because you have to make contact and then take it away a little bit. Now in order to make electrical contact with a normal torch, you also need to have bare metal or at least a conductive layer in order to create the contact. So when you have paint or corrosion or something that is non-conductive, you first need to clean your metal. Now that's also an advantage with a pilot arc because it will start up automatically and it will also burn away the non-conductive layer. Now is it possible to modify the Cut 60 into a pilot arc? So let's do the test. So let's first remove the conductor. Now this is a cheap Chinese torch which should fit. Now let's see. So the supply cable fits very well. So we now hooked up the torch to the Cut 60. It all fits well. This cable should be connected with the earth of your system. Now we do it now like this. And then we can see if it works. Well, let's try it. Now how does it work? For starting the plasma they will use this connection towards the cone of the device, and as soon as the plasma has started then you have of course a conductive medium and then the plasma is doing the conduction. So as you can see it actually works on the Cut 60 with the pilot arc. The nice thing is by the way that all the spare parts of this torch are exactly the same than with the original torch. You can even exchange the cups if you want, but also the electrodes are exactly the same. So you can still use your old spare parts. Now the only thing we now need to do is to modify the Cut 60 in order to have a proper electrical connection. And for this electrical connection I will use a standard plug by which it will be very easy to connect the pilot arc onto the Cut 60. So I will now remove the cover and put this female connector onto the front side of the Cut 60. Now here you see on the inside where the connection needs to be made. So we have to make a connection from this and going towards the side. Now this is the bolt that comes out of this connection, and this is the side of the plasma cutter, and as you can see it can go over. So I will use a small part of this cable of the pilot arc torch. I will connect it towards this new connector. I will solder it. Then I can mount it onto the Cut 60 and I can connect a new connector, this one over here. Then I will have a proper connection. Now I have to be smart because I will drill a hole of 9 mm in order to connect this new connector. But this part is larger. So I will first cut it, put it through the hole, then make the soldering, and then put it back. Because otherwise, I can't fit this connection to the hole of the connector. So let's now hook it back up. So it's now completely hooked up. As you can see, the pilot arc is also connected via the new connector. Now with this torch there's a cover over the trigger. That makes of course a lot of sense, because this torch doesn't need to have contact now anymore. Pushing the trigger will really result in the plasma coming out. Let's do a test. So as you can see, it works great. The torch is now igniting without contact due to this extra connection. So now we'll take some metal and give it a test run. So what we'll use now this metal to try it out. As you can see, it's quite thick and it's also painted. So it's good material to do a plasma cut test. So we did some cuts with the new plasma torch with the pilot arc. This one is already quite nice, quite a nice cut, 8mm steel. Here I also cut it and I already started to round it off, because that's what I need to have in the project. You will see in another video. And this is 9mm steel. This was the first one that I cut. Still a little bit rough, but also there I needed to see how it all works. I really like the plasma torch with the pilot arc, because when you now push the trigger, you immediately see the plasma flame as well as the shape. So you see the position of the flame, but also the shape of it. And by the shape, you can now tell up front already that you need to replace the electrodes, for example. Also, you can see that when you're holding it and the flame's coming out, that you need to hold it a little bit different. Of course, another advantage is that you now can put in the cups with the distance holder. And you can also now use a liner that you make contact with and follow a certain path. So I really like the modification of the Cut 60 into a Pilot Arc system. As you can see, it all fits well with this torch. The only thing that you need to do is to add a small contact that is connected to the earth. And that's it. And then you have a system that is much easier to use. So I'm really looking forward to do some new projects with the Pilot Arc torch. Thanks for watching. See you next time.